Welcome back to my channel, guys. And in this video, I'm going to be talking about the most anticipated motorcycle in the history of entry-level sports bike in India, and that's about the CBR 250RR, which is already released in the international market back in 2017. But since then, most of the CBR 250R owners in India have been waiting for this model to be getting launched in India as well. But Honda is trying to be ignore or an arrogant company. No, I don't think so, because though this company was one of the first company to launch the entry level sports bike back in 2011. When they launched the CBR 250R, which has the one of the best technology, which had one of the best technology back in the time, even now it is on par with every bike, whichever you compete with it. So everything done by Honda, they do it ahead of the time. They think about the future and they do the engineering on their motorcycle. And CBR 250RR is one of those motorcycles which is considered to be a halo product for them, or a premium bike category for them. And before getting started with this video, I want to give a little bit of a history lesson. Not that boring kings and kingdom history lessons, but a interesting one. Back in 1992, CBR 250RR was an inline 4 motorcycle. A 250cc inline 4 sounds great, right? And even the actual sound was great. Have a listen to it. This motorcycle was a very, very expensive motorcycle back then, and because of its noise, after some rules and regulations provided or given by the government, eventually the motorcycle has to be cancelled for the production, since it had a red line of 18,500 RPM, and 18,500 RPM is actually double of what we are getting now in most of the motorcycles. So that's the reason it was cancelled in 1988, I think, and it was producing somewhere around 45 to 43 horsepower and 23.5 Newton meters of torque, and it had a top speed of 200 kilometers per hour back in 1995. And for a 250 motorcycle back in 1995, that was an next level thing. Even now it is a next level thing. If you see, even now most of the 400cc bikes are not able to keep up with that numbers. So why CBR 250R is not launched in India, though it is available in the international market? So that's the main question which I'm going to be talking about in this video. So the number one reason is the price. Now there are two inline two motorcycle which are already there in India market, though the Yamaha R3 has been discontinued now. There is Ninja 300 as well, and both of these motorcycles comes on road 3.7 lakhs for the Ninja 300, and when the Yamaha R3 was there, it was 4.3 to 4.4 lakhs on road in Bangalore. So that's a very, very high price for a 300cc motorcycle. So considering that, the 250RR, which has an amazing technology, if you look at its digital console, you find everything. You find the speedometer, the gear position indicator, temperature meter, real-time mileage gauge, different type of modes, everything is available. There's a ride-by-wire technology now, so everything is awesome in this motorcycle. So amount of tech in it makes it more costlier than the inland two motorcycles which are there already in India. And it even CBR 250R has an inline two engine, and the 2020 model which has been released by Honda produces 41.2 bhp and around 23 to 22 newton meters of torque, and that is a very very high number. And the most amazing thing is these power figures are produced at very late very high rev range, and the horsepower is 41.2, and this has been producing at 12,500 rpm, and the peak torque comes around 10,000 rpm. If you see these amount of numbers, so it's pretty high in the rev range, and this is one of the most amazing thing, and why this has been a fantastic motorcycle in the international market and an immediate hit in the international market as well. So if you consider its looks, and hands down I have to be frank, even the CBR, the Fireblade, I mean I'm talking about the last gen which was released in 2017, the Fireblade which was released in 2017 should have looked like this. Both the motorcycles were released in the same year, but if the Fireblade would have looked like this, damn, it would be a sexier machine. I'm not telling that the Fireblade which they released was bad, it was awesome too, but if it was not as sharp looking as the 250RR, it was like a more of a flow wavy kind of a look for it. There was no sharp edges which most of the people like. So this 250RR is an amazing machine in terms of look. If this motorcycle will release in India correctly priced, it will be, I don't know what to say, Honda sales will exceed Activa as well. So that's one of the most annoying thing for Honda, that CBR 250R is beating Activa in terms of sales. And the second reason why it's not being yet launched in India is, if you see in the internet, Honda has been building these premium showrooms in India called Big Wing. So a Big Wing showroom has been already opened in Gurgaon, and only premium bikes are sold in these showrooms, like the CBR 650R, which has been an instant hit after releasing in India. It has a very positive approach for everyone, whoever is looking for a middleweight sports bike, and only premium motorcycles are sold here. So they are expanding this Big Wing showrooms across India in major cities. So I have a feeling that CBR 250RR will be that premium bike which will be released maybe later this year or in the next year in these premium showrooms. So they are not gonna sell this bike in the ordinary showrooms where you have to wait for its service next to a Honda Shine or Honda Hornet or Honda X-Blade. Honda is trying to up their ante in the terms of premium level of sports bike. So that's the reason they are separating the commuter friendly motorcycles to a separate showroom, and they are separating the premium showroom. That's the amount of care, or that's the amount of detail they are taking now. If you find any information that is useful for you, make sure you subscribe to the channel, because I am also a CBR 250R owner, and I have been using this motorcycle from past 1 year or so, which I bought in the used bought it in the used market. So I am also an eager owner who is waiting for this model to be launched in India. And that's all for this video, guys. And if you have found this video informational, or if you have learned anything new in this video, make sure you subscribe to my channel. And there are more videos which I'm going to be uploading in this channel. So if you have friends, and share the video to all the CBR 250R owners as well. And that's it, guys. Stay safe, stay at home, and don't panic. Everything is gonna be all right. Peace.